Good morning, and welcome to the third meeting of the Senate, New York State Senate Committee on Higher Education. We are joined today by Senator Cooney, Senator Gorin, Gennardis, Liu, Senator Griffo, Senator Oberacker, and our ranking member, Senator Boyle. Today is Tuesday, March 2nd. And it is 11:30 a.m. Joining us are the committee staff, Jan Dorman, Director of Higher Education of the Higher Education Committee. Is Nikki on?
Nikki is not on.
We are joined by Beth LaMountain, the committee clerk. Beth, is there a quorum present?
There is a quorum.
Today, the committee will take up a concurrent resolution of the Assembly and the Senate, and five bills. The first matter is Senate Resolution B-438 by Senator Mayer and Senator Stavisky. It's a concurrent resolution of the Senate and Assembly providing for the election of four regents of the University of the State of New York. Are there any questions or comments?
Madam Chair?
Yes, Senator Boyle.
I have not seen them. Is it possible before this comes, before we have the vote, obviously, in a joint session or however we're going to do it, to see the resumes of these individuals?
Yes, we will get them to you. I apologize. I should have gotten them to you. There are four individuals, two incumbents, Senator Dr. Reyes and Ms. Elizabeth Hackensan, and we have a vacancy in the 7th Judicial District to be filled by Ruth B. Turner, and a vacancy, in the 7th District in Rochester area, Monroe County, et cetera, was caused by the resignation of Regent Brown, and the other vacancy is the 12th Judicial District for a term of 2 years, caused by the resignation of Betty Rosa when she became Commissioner of Education. And that will be filled, hopefully, by Dr. Aramina Vega Ferrer. I apologize for not getting you the resumes ahead of time.
No problem.
It's a separate resolution. The vote will be at each house. We do not need a joint session. Are there any other questions or comments? Is there a motion to move the resolution? Beth, will you?
Senator Liu, move.
I make a motion to move the resolution. Senator Parker.
Yeah, Senator Parker, thank you. Is there a second? Senator Liu?
Senator Liu is raising his hand.
Senator Liu, second.
Yes, I do. I second.
Thank you.
It is a unanimous vote.
Thank you. That's good. The resolution has passed the Senate Education Committee earlier this morning, and it will be reported to the floor for consideration. The first bill on the agenda is Senate 3543 by Senator Stavisky. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law and authorizes the State Education Department to collect as part of the registration or re-registration process information about the practice of certain health professions certified, licensed, or registered pursuant to Title VIII of the education law. It exempts the practice of medicine from this requirement. There are three memos in support, one from the Greater New York Hospital Association, one from Healthy Minds, Healthy Kids, and from the State University of New York, SUNY. There are no memos in opposition, and there's no fiscal implication in this bill. If reported, this bill would be reported to the floor. If enacted, this bill would take effect immediately.
Move the bill.
Second.
There's a second?
Jim Gorin seconds.
Thank you, Senator Gorin. Any All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation?
It is a unanimous vote.
Unanimous vote. The bill is reported to the floor. The second bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 3826 by Senator Grifo. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law in allowing eligible non-resident undergraduate students to pay separate tuition rates for attendance at the State University College of Arts and Sciences at Potsdam. This bill passed the Senate in 2017, 2018, and 2019. There are no members of support, but there is a memo of opposition from the Commission on Independent Colleges and Universities, KIKU. The bill's fiscal implications are still to be determined. If reported, this bill will be reported to the floor. If enacted, the bill would take effect immediately, and it will expire and be deemed repealed on June 1, 2027.
Move the bill.
Bill's been moved by Senator second. Parker. A second.
Second.
Over. Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation?
It is unanimous.
The bill is reported to the floor. The third bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 4082 by Senator Hinchey. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law to expand eligibility for the New York State Young Farmers Loan Forgiveness Incentive Program. This bill removes the requirement that eligible persons must have graduated from college within the previous 2 years and is replaced with the qualification that a person must have farmed for more than 10 consecutive years. This bill passed the Senate in 2019. There are no members of support or opposition, and its fiscal implications are to be determined. If reported, this bill will be reported to the Finance Committee. If enacted, this act would take effect on the 90th day after it becomes a law.
Move the bill.
Are there any questions before Senator Parker moves the bill? Hearing none, the bill is moved by Senator Parker. Is there a second?
Senator Liu.
Senator Liu seconds it. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation, it is unanimous. The bill is reported to the Finance Committee. The fourth bill on the agenda is Senate 4219 by Senator Savisky. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law in relation to state appropriations to the State University of New York and the City University of New York, and also includes SUNY's healthcare science centers in the SUNY maintenance of effort provision. There are memos of support from NYSIT and from PEF, and there are no members in opposition. The fiscal implications for the state are yet to be determined. If reported, this bill will be reported to the Finance Committee. If enacted, this act would take effect immediately.
Move the bill.
Second. Any questions? Bill is moved by Senator Parker.
Second.
Second.
Seconded by Senator Grifo. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation. Bill is reported to the Finance Committee. The fifth
Madam
and
Chair.
Yes, sir.
I think you can remind Senator Parker that he needs to wait for you to ask if there are any questions before he moves the bill. And that way the rest of us can have a chance to move the bill also.
I move that motion.
I second.
I second.
I rule you're out of order. So noted. I tried to accommodate all of our members. The last bill is Senate 4533 by Senator Brooke. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law in relation to disabled students seeking to increase duration limits for student financial aid awards and gives authority to the Commissioner of Education to extend student financial aid awards for disabled students. This bill previously passed the Senate in the 2015-16 session and the 2017-2018 session. There are memos of support from the Commission on Independent Colleges and Universities and from NYSIT, and there are no memos in opposition. The fiscal implications are still to be determined. If reported, this bill will be reported to the Finance Committee. If enacted, this act would take effect on the 90th day after it shall have become law.
Are there any questions?
Move the bill.
I have a comment, Madam Chair.
Yes, Senator Liu.
Sorry. I'm sorry. There's a comment from Senator Jackson. Sorry for the update.
It can be after the bill is moved. I have a comment.
No, that's all right.
My comment is I am so happy for this bill, understanding that we're talking about students that may have a disability taking longer to graduate from college, and the awards are only for 4 years. It's ridiculous. If you look at the average student has taken more than 4 years to graduate. I took 5 years to graduate. And so some people are taking longer than that. But to make sure that there's a bill there so that children with disabilities will get funding beyond 4 years is clearly appropriate. And I thank Senator Brooke for putting this forward. Thank you. Now you can do whatever you need to do.
Well, Madam Chair, I'd like to concur. Madam Chair, I concur with Senator Jackson's comments. They are important. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other comments or questions?
Move the bill.
Bill has been moved. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Aye. Without recommendation, the bill will be reported to the Finance Committee. I want to thank you all for coming today, and it is now 11:42, this concludes today's meeting of the Senate Committee on Higher Education. Thank you.